Welcome back, plant people. Today, I have a very special spotlight on a plant that has captured the hearts of many with its stunning foliage and unique characteristics. Join me as we dive into the captivating world of the Calathea orbifolia plant. In this video, I'm going to show you how I have grown my gorgeous Calathea orbifolia. I'll be sharing all my tips and tricks with you, so stay tuned. I first acquired my Calathea orbifolia plant, this one, a couple of years ago. So I've had this plant for about 2 years now. And let me tell you, it was love at first sight. The broad round leaves with its intricate patterns of vibrant green and silver white veins just instantly caught my attention. Let's take a journey step by step through time and see how my Calathea orbifolia has grown and flourished under my care. Each step has been pivotal to getting my plant to look the way it does, so keep watching. Step number one was moving the plant from soil to Leca. You saw this one coming, didn't you? I placed this plant in Leca as soon as it arrived in my home, and I used growth technology Clonix clone solution in the reservoir for a couple of months to help with the transition. And you can purchase growth technology Clonix clone solution. Please find the link and the discount code in the description below. So I washed the plant and I put it directly in the Leca, and which had been soaking in Clonix clone solution. So no long method for this baby, it just went straight in there. And then of course I controlled the conditions. That was step number two. I initially placed this plant in a grow tent where I was able to control the light and the humidity, and it was exposed to grow lights for about 14 hours a day and humidity of not less than about 70%. And this allowed the plant to establish itself and develop strong roots. Lighting and humidity play a very crucial role in the well-being of any Calathea, and mine was no exception. Stay tuned for more insights on this topic coming up shortly. What did I do to feed this baby? So 2 months after the transition from soil to Leca, I switched nutrition from Clonix clone solution to foliage focus. And that is what I feed it to this day. As the plant grew, it eventually outgrew the confines of the grow tent. It is huge. And I then found it a space in my home. It's got a regular indoor spot. And although it no longer resides in the controlled environment of the grow tent, it thrives under the normal indoor light and humidity conditions. As for humidity, I maintain a moderate level by grouping it together with other plants, and I also use a humidifier when I can. Another step that's absolutely essential for taking care of your Calathea is leaf care. I regularly clean my leaves and I keep them dust-free using my Pest DETERRENT spray. Find the recipe in the video linked above and in the description below. This deterrent keeps the pests away, and it allows those gorgeous leaves not only to look good, but to be able to photosynthesize effectively. I'll give a more in-depth analysis on leaf care a little bit later. Now that you've seen the growth journey and learned about the care practices for this magnificent plant here, let's dive into some best care practices to ensure that your Calathea orbifolia thrives. Tip number one is light. Light is a very essential factor in a plant's growth and development. It plays a very important role in photosynthesis, which is the process by which the plant converts light into chemical energy or food. The Calathea orbifolia is a shade-loving plant, and it does thrive under bright indirect sunlight conditions. And this really is mimicking the natural habitat, because the Calathea orbifolia is often shaded by taller trees and receives filtered sunlight. So we're wanting to mimic the dappled sunlight of the forest floor. So you want to grow your Calathea orbifolia in bright but indirect light. Exposing it to direct sunlight can result in the leaves scorching, and insufficient light can actually lead to weak growth and very faded foliage. So the duration of light exposure is actually a very important aspect to consider. Calathea orbifolias thrive with consistent light period, and that means that it benefits from a regular day to night cycle. So ideally, you're providing your plant with about 10 to 12 hours of light per day, followed by a period of darkness or rest. So you're not keeping those grow lights on 24 hours. And to provide the best care for your Calathea orbifolia, start by finding a suitable spot with bright but indirect sunlight, again, avoiding that direct scorching light. Artificial light sources such as LED grow lights are also fabulous sources of full spectrum light to get your Calathea growing as well as it can, because they closely mimic the natural wavelengths of the sun. There's links in the description to grow lights that you can use to help you grow your Calathea. Now, if you're as captivated by the Calathea orbifolia as I am, be sure to hit that like button, click the subscribe button, and hit the notification bell so you won't miss any upcoming videos. Tip number two is humidity. You all know this. The Calathea orbifolia is a tropical plant. It thrives in environments with a higher humidity. Again, we're wanting to mimic what it's like in the forest where it grows. So humidity plays a very crucial role in its overall health and well-being. Humidity affects the various processes that the plant goes through: gas exchange, transpiration, photosynthesis. All this is really important. Transpiration is a process by which plants release water vapor through their leaves, and the Calathea orbifolia relies on transpiration to regulate its internal temperature, nutrients absorption, and moisture balance. So in an environment where the humidity is low, transpiration will be compromised, and this leads to leaf curling, browning, and just overall stress of the plant. So keeping an adequate level of humidity around your Calathea orbifolia does help to promote healthy transpiration and prevents excessive loss of moisture through the leaves. And by doing this, the foliage of your plant is going to be absolutely fantastic. There are methods that you can use to increase the humidity around your Calathea orbifolia. First among them is grouping. This is a very easy way. Place your Calathea in and amongst other plants, and by doing that, you create a microclimate with higher humidity levels, because as plants are releasing moisture through transpiration, all those plants are releasing moisture, and that moisture is actually benefiting all of them. So that's a very simple way. The next way is consider using a humidifier. Ideally, you're aiming for humidity levels between 50 to 60%, again, which closely mimic rainforest conditions. It is important to note that while your Calathea orbifolia appreciates that high humidity, it's equally essential to maintain good airflow to prevent the development of fungal diseases. Proper ventilation ensures a healthy balance between the humidity and the air circulation. Experiment and find out what works best in your home environment. If you're finding this video informative and want to receive more valuable tips and insights in plant care, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to my channel. Tip number three is watering. Calathea orbifolias thrive when their soil is kept consistently moist but not waterlogged. The root system of a Calathea orbifolia has a very fine, delicate roots, and they absorb water and nutrients from the soil. And so overwatering leads to excessive moisture in the root zone, depriving the roots of oxygen, which results in root rot and other related issues. You need to allow the top edge of the soil to dry before watering again, and always use room temperature water. Avoid letting the plant sit in excess water, as again, this can lead to root rot. But how do you know when it's time for you to water your Calathea orbifolia? Using a moisture meter, link in the description below, helps you to determine when you need to water your plant if you're growing your plant in soil. Growing your plant in semi-hydroponics, however, or Leca, takes the guesswork out of knowing when to water your plant, as it always has access to water and nutrition from the reservoir. For me, growing my plant in Leca is the best option, and my Calathea orbifolia is growing in Leca. Tip number four, fertilize your plant. Fertilizers provide essential nutrients, essential elements that might be lacking in the soil, and therefore support the plant's metabolic processes and photosynthesis. So the plant needs these nutrients. Fertilize your Calathea orbifolia regularly. Consider using a balanced fertilizer with the essential minerals that a plant needs and follow the manufacturer's instructions for application. I use a Foliage Focus by Growth Technology. Link and discount code is found in the description below. Tip number 5 is leaf care. Another really important aspect of Calathea orbifolia care is maintaining clean and a dust-free environment. Dust can accumulate on the leaves, affecting their ability to photosynthesize effectively. Dust particles on the leaf surface create a barrier that reduces the amount of light reaching the chloroplasts, where photosynthesis occurs. Chloroplasts contain chlorophyll, which is the pigment responsible for capturing the light energy used in the photosynthesis process. So, when dust covers the leaf surface, it stops the absorption of light and it reduces the plant's ability to convert carbon dioxide and water into food and oxygen. And of course, this will lead to your plant becoming weak and its overall health is going to be impaired, and then it's just going to look a bit sad. So to prevent all these issues, just regular cleaning of the leaves is absolutely essential. You can use a damp cloth. Take a soft damp cloth or sponge and gently wipe the leaves to remove dust particles. This method helps physically dislodge dust without causing harm to the delicate leaf surface. Another effective technique is to shower the plant, mimicking a gentle rain. Place your Calathea orbifolia in the bathroom or take it outdoors in the shower, ensuring that the water is at room temperature. Allow the water to flow gently over the leaves, rinsing away accumulated dust. Avoid using high pressure sprays or excessively cold or hot water, as it can damage the foliage. Tip number 6 is pest control. And while this plant is generally resilient, it can occasionally fall victim to common pests that hinder its growth and overall health. Pests that can affect the Calathea orbifolia include spider mites, mealybugs, aphids, fungus gnats, and so on. And these pests can cause damage by feeding on the plant's leaves or roots, leading to leaf discoloration, stunted growth, and even plant decline if left unaddressed. As with any plant, it's crucial to monitor for pests. Keep an eye out for common invaders such as spider mites and mealybugs. Regularly inspect your Calathea orbifolia for any signs of pest activity, such as webbing, discolored leaves, or tiny insects. Remove any affected leaves or pests promptly to prevent further spread. Follow the principles described and you can also have a Calathea orbifolia that looks like this. Watch this next video to learn how you can grow your Porphos mandula to look like this. See you there.